Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today is Alastair Clayton, Executive Director at Artemis Resources. Alastair, good to meet you. How are you today?
Yeah, great. Great to meet you, Christy.
Alastair, it's been a while since we've had you on the Proactive platform. So for any new listeners watching today, can you reintroduce Artemis to us?
Sure. Look, as of next Monday, Artemis will be a dual-listed London, Sydney gold, copper exploration company. We recently, last week, raised about 5 million sterling and will, as I mentioned, first day of dealing is on Monday, the 7th of February, which we're really looking forward to.
Yeah, congratulations on that. What was the rationale behind the dual listing?
Yeah, it's something we thought long and hard about it, actually. Essentially, our primary asset or our number one exploration asset is a discovery that's been effectively made out of London, even though it's in Australia, which is, I think I described last week as an historical quirk. And as such, there's a really strong understanding of what we're trying to achieve. And to be frank, what the size of the prizes on offer are out there. So we took a view Q3 last year to push ahead with the listing and really pleased to be staring down the barrel of that on Monday.
Just remind us a bit more about your core assets.
Sure. Look, the exploration project that I'm sure lots of your listeners will be very familiar with. I actually watched one of your interviews with the CEO of Greatland Gold yesterday. Look, it's an exploration area that surrounds what I believe is one of the best gold discoveries, certainly of my professional career, shaping up in the sort of 20 plus million ounce size. And through good luck and good management, Artemis has the ground surrounding that, and we've always believed, and I think we're demonstrating that now with our own work, that the geology and the structures that caused that multi-billion dollar discovery just a couple of kilometers away continues into our ground.
For those who aren't familiar with the area, what are some of the kind of challenges of operating in Western Australia?
Yeah, look, you know, I think we're all pretty familiar, you know, throughout the world of various jurisdictions having various rules. Obviously, Western Australia has been effectively COVID-free. That will probably come to an end at some stage, but that, of course, in supply chains and personnel provides a lot of pressure on companies such as us to fight for people and men and machinery. Look, our simple philosophy is to plan early, plan hard, and plan for disappointment. And thus far, I'm really proud to say we've delivered on time. In terms of getting drill rigs especially, and I expect that to continue.
On the flip side, what are the advantages of being in Western Australia?
Yeah, look, again, be careful what you wish for. Thus far, the disruption has been very limited. We've been able to get on with our work sort of safely and efficiently. But yeah, it's been challenging. I'm coming to you from Europe. I haven't been back to Australia for 2 years. And luckily, we've got a great senior management team based in Australia as well. But yeah, like all CEOs, all business owners out there, it's tough.
Yeah, we are seeing a increase in demand for gold here in this kind of inflationary period. So are you well positioned to capitalize on this?
Look, I think so. Look, you know, just looking across the board and, you know, I've been involved in the industry for a long time. I actually tend to disappoint people a bit. I take a pretty agnostic view. I think if you've got really high quality assets, of course, you welcome a high price. But yeah, I mean, I'd only make the observation that I think we're all told at the end of last year that crypto's the new gold and crypto halved and gold went up. So, you know, it depends on your, as they say, on your investment requirements. But yeah, I think gold always has a place in people's portfolios and I think we're just seeing more of the same.
So give us a sense of the kind of catalyst we should be looking out for from Artemis in 2022, obviously besides this listing.
Yeah, absolutely. Look, corporate moves are all well and good, but it all comes down to the sharp end of the stick, effectively. Look, we'll be updating the market on Monday about our drill plans. We're extremely well advanced, but really it's about getting back out there, following up on the great work we did in the Patersons at the end of 21, where we certainly saw some very encouraging signs. While we don't have scientific, you know, assays at the moment, we're really excited at what we've seen there. And then, of course, at our other project, the Greater Carlow project, which again will be kicking off real soon as well. So for us, we just see a full 2020 of basically nonstop drilling across the portfolio.
Alistair, really appreciate the update here. Thank you so much.
Thanks for your time.